wonderful marriages in this place in which we're now at. As family and friends are gathered here today to celebrate the marriage of Ian and Sophie, on their behalf, I'd like to welcome you all. I know it means a lot to them that you could be here to share in their happiness on this occasion. Through their vows, they're making a commitment to each other for the rest of their lives. For Ian and Sophie, it is my duty to remind you of the solemn and legally binding character of the vows. I do solemnly declare that I know not of any lawful impediment why I, Ian, I do solemnly declare may not be joined with the matrimony, that I know not of any lawful impediment why I, so the believe. For better
for
richer, for
poor,
in sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
For the rest of our lives together. I call for thee my lawful wedded husband. To have and to hold. For better, for richer, for poor, in sickness and in health. Sophie, I give you this ring.
Sophie, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
And for my marriage today. In the name of this ring, I give you this ring. As a symbol of my love. As a symbol of my love. Today is the start of a new life together. We hope that the feeling of love will be happy. I declare that you, Ian Fallon, Sophie Williams, daughter, Pastor Brunel, and I join together in matrimony in accordance with love. It's a great pleasure to hear your husband and wife, and you make me kiss you.
Right. You know. So that's what she said. That's
Thank you.
come back from Afghanistan. Thank you very much, guys. I have to say a few words now. I put this on the internet. I have to say a few words on my youngest son, my amphibious son. Where's Jerry? That's a tenner young. I managed to put that in. I've known him since we were a tadpole. Yes, because we were in quarters in Germany. We had a nice big quarter with a big cellar, and we had a games room down there for the dance sports. And one Saturday afternoon, we were sitting, minding our own business, and not came to the door. And we actually shared the quarters with the Americans at the time. The quarter area, not the same quarter. And I opened the door, and there was the biggest American I've ever seen in my life standing there, and he was from the south. Now I would give you a southern and Scottish accent, but he had a young girl with him, his daughter, who was only about five, and he said to me, he says, "Your son has injured my daughter." So well,
so early.
So early. Very thought went through my mind as well. Being amphibious and all that, you know. Anyway, I said, how's my son injured your daughter? And he said, he threw a dart at her. And I said, I don't think he would have done that. And he said, yes he did. I says, how do you know? And he turned around and the dart was sticking out of her back. She had principles, because you know, she was running at the time. Another story I'm going to tell is that Ian was a fairly decent footballer, still is, and his brother as well was a footballer. That's another tenor of Yomi Stewart. One Saturday they were both at home, both and I said to Kristen, I'll split my time between them. I'll go down and watch Ian, watch Stewart for the first half, and I'll go and watch Stewart and Corey for the second half. There again. Well, we're only 10 minutes into the game for coach Stewart when this red-headed thing flying on and take this guy out, chest him out. He obliterated him into the and he stood up. So he was red carded and he went off, so I spent the rest of the half just watching the game. I got in the car and I got to Corain, and I got the second half of the Corain game, and when they came out, I was looking at the players and I said, "Cheerio." And I said to the boy next to me, I said, "You can't not play today," he says, "We're sent off."
Not only we are family, but Royal Marines, we consider ourselves a family, so
I'd like to thank the MI Super for not making it.
And I would like to add that the Queen did mention us in her Diamond Jubilee speech. She did not mention the Paras. So, Amphibious 1, Airborne 0. And last but not least, I'd like to a special thanks to the mother and father who absolutely dug out blind, pulled us out of a few holes to make all this worthwhile. And I hope everyone else enjoys the rest of the day. Night.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. On the same wavelength, same sense of humour, everything. Going out on nights out, it's very much the same. Ian's not shy of a beer, as you're going to find out tonight. Pretty much like the lads on the table, not shy of a beer. One thing that stuck out to me about Ian was his toilet antics after a night out. Every time taking his t-shirt off and mistaking it for a urinal. So all I can hope is that Sophie has got her toilet drained up to now. Just like to say as well, unfortunately all the lads from our company, one true country.